The VACE model for wan2.2 is finally out, and it's the official version. So, what exactly is its effect like? Let's take a look. We have conducted a three-aspect evaluation of this model. For example, we can provide an image, and we want the character in that image to perform corresponding actions based on our prompts. Everyone, take a look. This effect is absolutely fantastic. The second aspect is that we added a driving video to make the character perform corresponding actions. Please take a look. This effect is still remarkably good. And finally, the last feature is the start and end frames, which many of you will enjoy. For instance, if we have two images now, one is the start frame and one is the end frame. After processing with the VAC model, you can see this kind of effect. This effect is also very amazing. So, everyone will notice that the official VAC model is indeed better in effect and more powerful compared to the community versions. Now, let's take a look at this model. This model was released by Alibaba's PA team. We can click to open the file list. We can see that there are high noise and low noise models. Each one is approximately 34 gigabytes in size. So, you can download this model and use it directly. However, the prerequisite is that your memory or VRM must be sufficient. Therefore, implementing this directly can be quite difficult. Fortunately, in the open source community, such as Kijai, corresponding support has already been provided. We can click on Kijai in the Hugging Face model repository list. Inside, there is a folder called Fun. This folder stores all the models developed by Alibaba's PI team. Here, you'll find the VACE model. After clicking on it, you will find these two models. This model is also called wan2.1 Fun VACE. But you need to pay attention. It is integrated as a module. This means it must be used in conjunction with the wan2.2 main model. Its size is relatively small, with each being only 6 gigabytes. Today, although we are using Kijai's modular VACE model, the workflow we constructed is a native ComfyUI workflow. Therefore, when using this main model, we are not using Kijai's wan2.2 model, but rather, Comfy's officially provided T2V wan2.2 model. So, please note this. Of course, in constructing the workflow, we need some specific techniques. Next, let's look at the workflow construction. I've built all the workflows on Running Hub. Everyone can access this platform through Running Hub. In the ComfyUI field, Running Hub should be a very excellent working platform because whenever new technologies are released, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub through the invitation link in my video description, which will grant you 1,000 free points. Additionally, if you log into Running Hub every day, you will also receive 100 points as a gift. This way, you can try your own workflows for free. Next, let's take a look at how this workflow is built. We'll start by looking at the simplest function, which is that we can give a subject character and have it generate a corresponding video according to our prompt. First, let's look at the main model loading part. This is quite technical. Take a look. In the KJ node, we have provided two things. One is called a diffusion model loader, which is the KJ version, and the other is a diffusion model selector. Here, we can select modules. Through such a connection, we can connect the main model and our module. Because the modular loading method that everyone commonly sees can only be used within Kijai's one video extension. But if we want to achieve the corresponding functionality without that extension, how do we do it? This primarily uses another extension called KJ node. Everyone needs to install this extension and then update it to the latest version. By using this extension, we can connect many of Kijai's functions with our native workflow. For example, in this current application, here, the main model we are loading is the official wan2.2 T2V high noise model. Similarly, this is for loading the low noise model. Then, how do we load the module? We use this node, and here we select the previously downloaded wan2.2 VACE model, which is a modular version. The difference between these two is that one is high noise and the other is low noise. After loading, let's look at our encoder and our V. There's nothing particularly special about these. To speed things up, we still loaded the light text to VLoRa. Now, let's look at the settings for the VACE module. First, we have an image here, which we need to resize so that its resolution aligns with the settings in our configuration. After that, everyone, please note that I have a node called Remove Background. If you are familiar with VACE, we all know that VACE has some techniques. For example, if I only wanted to refer to this character and don't want the background or other elements to influence my final video, I can remove the background using this background removal node. However, you must note that if we want to achieve the corresponding function, the background is best filled with white. This is the same as with the wan2.1 VACE model. So, everyone, please pay attention to these two options here, and make sure to select correctly. One is that the background must be set to color, never alpha. After that, we can select a color here. We choose pure white, so it's 255, 255, 255. When we preview it, we can see this effect. Then, we can use the node called wan2.2 to video. Everyone is very familiar with this node. We need to input our positive conditions and negative conditions. The positive and negative conditions are essentially the parts of our prompt. My prompt is very simple. This woman is running on the road. Regarding the VAC part here, we mainly use something called reference image. We connect this background removed image to it. This way, we can generate new positive conditions, negative conditions, our latent, and the number of frames we need to trim. Next, we move to our sampling section. This is very simple. It's just that our positive and negative conditions use those processed by the VACE node. Additionally, you need to note that the input for the first latent is also the latent processed by VACE, of course. During the second low noise sampling, this latent becomes the latent output by the high noise model. In the sampling settings, everyone, please note that the sampler I used is LCM. The first four steps are high noise sampling, and the next four steps are low noise sampling. And similar to 1.2.1 feet seconds VAC, the video we generate needs to undergo a trimming stage. Therefore, we have a trim amount here. This is mainly determined by the trim latent generated here, which decides how many frames to trim. This is how it's always handled in the official VACE workflow. I'm just emphasizing it here. Now, let's look at the generated effect. Everyone, please pay attention. We can make a small comparison. First, we'll notice that the consistency is very strong, and the processing is very refined, with very natural movements. I believe this effect far surpasses 1.2.1, especially in maintaining the consistency of the character. In fact, in many community and third-party VACE models, the character's eyes, hair, or facial features might appear blurry or unclear at this resolution, which is 832 by 480. But you should note that this official VACE version handles facial features, hair, and even eyes with great detail. This is the first, very familiar function of VACE. Alright, next, let's look at the second function. The second function is actually an extension of the first function, adding action guidance. The previous parts are largely the same, so I won't repeat them. The only difference is that in this workflow, we've added a control video. This control video is provided by an additional video. Take a look. I have a video here of a girl in a swimming pool with very complex movements. Then, we use a preprocessor like DW OpenPose to extract her movements and then resize it to match our original resolution. We will get a video like this. This video is essentially a posture representation video. Everyone is very familiar with this. We connect this video to our control video input. Now let's look at the generated effect. Firstly, the character's consistency is still very well maintained. The character's action transfer is also very accurate. If you absolutely have to pick out its shortcomings, we can only say this. In the parts not appearing in the reference image, her attire isn't particularly well matched, because my reference image only showed the upper body wearing a golden armor. And if you look at the generated lower body part, it's actually jeans, which is not very suitable. If you want to solve this problem, it's very simple. You should clearly describe the girl's basic appearance in the prompt. This way, the parts not appearing in the reference image, like the jeans part, can also be handled very well. You can try this yourself. This is our second very important VACE workflow. Then, the third one is the very familiar start and end frame feature. I have two images here, one for the start frame and one for the end frame. Both of these images will go through a resize node. Here, we will use a Kijai node called one video from start to end frame. This is also very familiar to everyone. We pass both the start frame and end frame to it. It will generate a new image and mask. Then we connect these respectively to control image and control mask. This way, we can achieve the effect of start and end frames. Let's look at the final state presented to us. Take a look. It's really great, right? Here's the start frame, and here's the end frame. Based on testing these three basic workflows, I believe that the fun version of VAS indeed far surpasses other community versions. Of course, you can create more combinations and explore more ways to use VAS. You can try them yourself. Alright, that's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.